dream? I
Well, who the fuck knows what that was about, but it's over. We're here now. Okay. Let's see how far we get today. So, I'm Riylo. And this is Kate, but a different Kate. In fact, there's a third Kate I'll probably bring in this time. So, oddly enough, there are three other people streaming Mass Effect right now. One of them with 83 viewers. But that's because it's Shanna Bear. So, she gets viewers doing anything. She can braid her hair and get viewers. She can pick her nose and get viewers. Why is this asking me? Fuck off. Why haven't I had to do this at all before? So that account has existed for this entire time without an avatar. Damn. Why couldn't I keep that going? What changed? Okay. So we were about ready to let Ashley die. Because I wanted to. So, I'm talking about the, how's the sound balance between me and the game? Some loud noises. I talked a little bit with Eksys about the channel. Almost there. You're about 6 coins short of crash. Potato. I should talk quieter.
I should talk more quietly. Eksys is sleeping.
So, the subjects came up. It was actually a subject that we talked about last year at VidCon. Not Eksys and I, but it came up. Good. So the subject came up of what is successful, what is you've made it, what is you're happy with your YouTube channel. And Game Dojo brought up this couple of emails. I don't remember the channel. I don't even know if he said it. But it was a channel with very few. I think they were putting out a video a day, or five videos a week, something like that, a year, or for 5 years. And they still had, what in the goddamn fuck? They still had something like 90 subs, and they are still putting out videos of both of them playing games. And so what is successful? Are they happy doing what they're doing? That sort of a thing. So yesterday, one of the recommended videos for me, every once in a while I still get recommended videos that have something to do with magic, and I'll click on them and listen to them once in a while just to hear what's going on. And at the beginning of the video, this guy was carrying around an Inquest magazine, and I thought, holy shit, I used to have that. I probably still have it, but man, I miss some of those. There were some of those that just friends had that I want to go look at. You know, how much would it take to pick up back issues? And the answer is not cheap, but I thought, you know what? I've got some housework to do. So, in the meantime, what I want to do is I want to listen to some magic history. So I searched for my favorite set of all time. So look, he just died. He just lost all his health in about a second. I don't understand this. And I wasn't really finding anything that I and of course it's closing. Why wouldn't it close? I pressed open, but instead it continues to close and doesn't open. I'm gonna press open again. Finally! Dead, but they revived on their own. I'm okay with this. That's how you take down a sniper.
The commander set that nuke pistol. Get out! We can't hold them! Damn it! Suppressing fire! Cover your flank! Cover your...
Diversion. Of course, it was all for nothing. I can't let you disrupt what I've accomplished here. You can't possibly understand what's really at stake.
Sovereign and its kind destroyed the Protheans. What else is there to understand?
You've seen the vision from the beacon, Shepard. You of all people should understand what the Reapers are capable of. They cannot be stopped. Do not mire yourself in pointless revolt. Do not sacrifice everything for the sake of petty freedoms. The Protheans tried to fight, and they were utterly destroyed. Trillions dead. But what if they had bowed before the invaders? Would the Protheans still exist? A submission not preferable to extinction.
Do you really believe the Reapers will let us live?
Now you see why I never came forward with this to the Council. We organics are driven by emotion instead of logic. We will fight even when we know we cannot win. But if we work with the Reapers, if we make ourselves useful, think how many lives could be spared. Once I understood this, I joined Sovereign, though I was aware of the dangers. I had hoped this facility could protect me.
You're afraid Sovereign is influencing you. You're afraid he's controlling your thoughts.
I've studied the effects of indoctrination. The more control Sovereign exerts, the less capable the subject becomes. That is my saving grace. Sovereign needs me to find the conduit. My mind is still my own, for now. But the transformation from ally to servant can be subtle. I will not let it happen to me.
Sovereign's manipulating you and you don't even know it! You're already under its power!
No, Sovereign needs me! If I find the conduit, I've been promised a reprieve from the inevitable. This is my only hope.
Again, another situation where I don't like any of the options.
Together, we can stop Sovereign. We don't have to submit to the Reapers, we can beat them!
I no longer believe that, Shepard. The visions cannot be denied. The Reapers are too powerful. The only hope of survival is to join with them. Sovereign is a machine. It thinks like a machine. If I can prove my value, I become a resource worth maintaining. There is no other logical conclusion.
This is the third time I've seen these fucking options. It's gonna force me to go through it until I pick the one that starts a fight. That's not what I was doing. And I wouldn't have picked the red one before just to pick the red one. I was more interested in how the story might have turned out if I had picked the blue one. I wanted to see if there was some sort of a turn that I could cause. That would have been more interesting to me.
You were a specter. You were sworn to defend the galaxy. Then you broke that vow to save yourself.
I'm not doing this for myself. Don't you see? Sovereign will succeed. It is inevitable. My way is the only way any of us will survive. I'm forging an alliance between us and the Reapers, between organics and machines. And in doing so, I will save more lives than have ever existed. But you would undo my work. You would doom our entire civilization to complete annihilation. And for that, you must die.
So this fight's gonna suck ass. Thank you. doing there? Sounds like an awesome cutscene I'm missing. Can't do anything. This fucking game. Well, it's recorded so they can go back and patch it. I'm sure they will. Put Mass Effect 2 Collector's Edition, Mass Effect 3 Collector's Edition, and Fallout New Vegas Collector's Edition, all of them still factory sealed up on eBay earlier today, and they've all got views. All of them got, got three watchers, that's good. Well, I did see the save symbol pop up when the fight ended, so hopefully that ends up being I saw it come up. Says to do for the next game I play. Well, a new game is coming here on Tuesday, so I'll be doing that alongside Mass Effect, two streams a day. Well, who knows what the hell happened during that cutscene. Let's fight these fucks. Wait, this is further back. I have to do that fucking goddamn fight over again. Well, my Fallout New Vegas isn't going for cheap, so I have to do this fucking fight. God damn it. Including the fight with what's-his-fuck. And I don't think I could save between him because I'm pretty sure... No, I can. What triggered it was walking out, so I should be able to save before fighting him, but after fighting these down here. So I guess to continue my story, although gunfight will be loud, let me know if I might as well not continue during a gunfight. So, I searched for a video on Weatherlight, and found a video that was, I wanted to find something recent. Oh, of course I missed the shot, because one of my dumb fuck teammates walked up in front of me. Isn't it dying? Now I'm almost dead. What?
Commander, set that nuke and get out. We can't hold them. Damn it. Suppressing fire. Cover your flank. Cover your...
Choices, they don't matter. I still haven't learned which one is which on this thing.
Lost shields.
Found a video that was done back in October, I think, and it only had something like 19 views. Oh, hey, a cutscene. Ashley, you were annoying. Yeah, I didn't hear that sound during that failed loaded cutscene. I can't believe that Ash didn't make it.
How could we just leave her down there?
There was no time. I couldn't save you both. The bomb was about to go off.
But why me? Why not her?
It wasn't your call, Alenko. I had to choose. I chose you.
But if I'd done my job, you wouldn't have had to make that call.
Williams is dead. We can't change that. But if we don't stop Saren, her sacrifice was made in vain.
Yes, ma'am. We'll get it done.
Commander, excuse me for interrupting, but I have an idea. I think the beacon you found in Saren's base was similar to the one you found on Eden Prime. It may have filled in the missing pieces of your vision. I might be able to help you put all those pieces together.
You want to join our minds again, don't you? Okay, go ahead.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity! Thought the images would be so intense. I need a moment to collect myself.
Did the vision make any sense to you?
She just said she needs a minute.
A distress call. A message sent out across the Prothean Empire. A warning against the Reapers, but the warning came
I'm
too
really
late.
I'm fucking tired of this little fucking thing. I don't know how to fix it, though.
What about the conduit?
There were other images, locations, places I recognized from my research. Ilos! The conduit is on Ilos! That is why Saren needed to find the new relay.
Squizzy.
It is the only way to get to Ilos.
We need to get to Ilos.
Forget it. The new relay's inside the Terminus systems. Alliance ships are not welcome there. Neither are Spectres.
The conduit's on Ilos. That's where Saren's heading. I'll be waiting for him when he gets there.
Saren will have his entire fleet orbiting Ilos. You will never make it down to the surface without reinforcements. You must alert the Council. We need a fleet to... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is... exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
That's the same line you had earlier.
We're done here. Dismissed.
This
Commander,
is the same line I had,
nearby.
And the same choices.
I can link us in if you want to report back to the Citadel Council. You know, to warn him about Sovereign.
Set the link up, Joker. They need to know.
Patching it through.
Commander Shepard, I'm pleased to see your mission on Vermaar was a success.
Saren is formidable enough without an army of Krogan serving under him.
The Krogan would have served Sovereign, a Reaper.
Yes, we saw mention of this on your report. Sovereign, Ascension Machine, a true artificial intelligence. This news is quite alarming, if it turns out to be accurate.
Sovereign's real. The Reapers are real. Saren even admitted it.
He's playing you, Shepard. Saren still has contacts on the Citadel. You probably saw your earlier reports, the ones talking about your vision and the Reapers.
It's highly possible Saren is using false information to throw you off balance. Our own intelligence has never turned up any corroborating information.
Sooner or later, you're gonna have to take something I say on faith, Counselor.
Try to see this from our perspective, Commander. Saren is a threat we can recognize. However, as far as we know, the Reapers only exist in your visions.
Our decisions affect trillions of lives. We cannot act on the accusations of a single person, even a Spectre. Not without solid evidence.
The Council cannot take any official action here. That is why we created the Spectres. You have the authority to act as you see fit.
If you truly believe Sovereign is the real threat, you must take whatever steps are necessary to stop it. And Saren.
Good luck, Commander. From all of us.
Might as well get what experience I can now. I'm not gonna go back through this game and find those guys, those 21 things, and so on. I'm not gonna play this game longer than I have to. Now, as far as I know, the trilogy should be getting here tomorrow.
I forwarded the mission update to the Citadel, Commander. We got confirmation on those reinforcements. Ambassador Udino wants us to report back to the Citadel. The Council's massing a joint species fleet to deal with Saren and his Geth.
Back to the Citadel, Joker. I want the Normandy at the head of that fleet.
Yes, ma'am.
So I watched this guy's video. He's a hell of a lot more animated than I would ever be.
Good job, Shepard. Thanks to you, the Council's finally taking real action against Saren.
The Ambassador is correct. If Saren is foolish enough to attack the Citadel, as you believe, we will be ready for him.
Patrols are stationed at every mass relay linking Citadel space to the Terminus systems.
How many ships are you sending to attack Ilos?
Ilos is only accessible to the Mu Relay, deep inside the Terminus systems, Commander. If we send a fleet in there, the only possible outcome is full-scale war.
Now is the time for discretion, Commander. Saren's greatest weapon was secrecy. Exposed, he is no longer a threat. This is over.
One ship going into the Terminus systems won't start a war. I can be discreet.
You detonated a nuclear device on Vermeer. I wouldn't call that discreet.
Your style served you well in the Traverse, Commander. We recognize that. But Ilos requires a deft touch. We have the situation under control.
Well, it seems like I can make arguments all the time, but it's going to force me to do this. I'm really
tired
of the decision, how
the
decision shit works in this game.
We have to go to Ilos.
Ambassador Udina, I get the sense Commander Shepard isn't willing to let this go.
There are serious political implications here, Shepard. Humanity's made great gains thanks to you, but now you're becoming more trouble than you're worth.
You bastard! You're selling us out!
It's just politics, Commander. You've done your job, now let me do mine. We've locked out all the Normandy's primary systems until for the notice you're grounded.
I don't like any of these responses.
Are you insane? After everything I have done, you still don't believe me.
I think it's time for you and your team to leave, Commander. This no longer concerns you. The Council can handle this with my help, of course.
Oh, of course. Are they gonna force me to do side quests?
Commander, I've got a message from Captain Anderson.
Are you spying on me, Joker?
No, ma'am. Just knew you were on the ship and figured I'd pass the message on. The captain said to meet him at Flux, that club down in the wards.
So
equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
I watched the video. It's alright. It's not exactly what I was looking for, but it was alright. So, I look for another video that's like it in his channel, and I notice something. This guy, he hasn't done much streaming, but he's done a lot of videos. And over the course of the last, I think it's 14 months, he's uploaded 450 videos. And he only had 116 subscribers. Some of his videos didn't have views. Including he actually did a stream here on YouTube Gaming and on Twitch. So I went
over
to Twitch.
After years of poor economic
performance,
Exogeny has announced that its research colony on Pharos is finally returning a profit. New discoveries and a dedicated colonization effort have finally paid off for Exogeny. Exogeny's stock rose sharply with the announcement, with investors pleased at this surprising news.
So he had, I think it was 9 or 11 videos on Twitch, streams. Two of them were actually discussions, like sort of a podcast type thing. And he does those here on YouTube as well. I don't know how many views those had on YouTube, but 9 or 11 videos on Twitch. And before I got there, or when I went to go and look at his chat library,
Commander Shepard,
he had one view total among all of them. And that was just... And the thing is, he is still going strong. He has averaged more than a video a day, and that's with having a 3-month break in the middle for 14 months now. And he's still going at it. He's got a Patreon set up with no patrons. And it's just a very weird situation. And he still wants to do it. He still wants to get that information out there. He still wants to... wards. I need to go to the wards. He still wants to put these videos out to do content creation, despite having videos with no views on them. And that's an admirable thing, but it's, you know, it's kind of sad. I'm not in a position. I'm not in the same position, but I'm not in a position where I can help him. So it's, you know, it's unfortunate. I want to be able to help someone like that. You know, he's not bad. And he knows what he's doing, he knows what he's talking about. And the thing is, you know, what can I do to help him? Well, I can't afford to go and sponsor people for the hell of it.
You know how stubborn your sister can be.
On Patreon. I can't even necessarily watch all of his videos. I'm gonna watch all of his magic history ones, but I don't have an interest in most of the rest of the stuff he talks about. He talks about D&D and a whole bunch of role-playing games and other similar games, going back years and years. He's probably got Netrunner stuff from back when it was actually a card game, not a board game. So it's, board game is a really weird definition these days. So you know, me subscribing to him, and I did, but all that did was bring him from 116 to 117. So that's not a great help, but and at the same time, I have a specific view. You know, I don't want subscribers who aren't going to be active, or at least interested in the content. I don't want fake subscribers. I don't want people to subscribe to me and have to deal with me in their feed when they don't want me to be there. That's not what I want. I want people who actually want to, who are entertained or whatever else. who want to discuss the same topics, who, you know, again, soft spot for game design, but, you know, I don't want to just push everyone to this guy's channel, because what's that going to do? That's not going to genuinely help him. So, it's really weird. I feel like that amount, and he's doing he's doing VODs. He's actually shooting and editing video. Fighting with this software, yes, it's a fucking hassle. But he's actually editing video. I haven't had to edit anything. And it just goes up. So in a way, I have it easier. He's got, with that 3-month break, over a video a day going back 14 months, 450 videos. That is an amount of dedication that should be rewarded more than what he is getting rewarded. And I just wish that if you put that much effort into it and you had a decent product, that you would get rewarded. But YouTube's tough.
I'm glad you came, Shepard. I heard what happened.
Okay, again, the writing in this game is fucking horrible. Right there. I heard what happened. So my response is, Udina sold me out. Which is what happened. He knows what happened. This is bad writing. And yet, this is something that I always heard about in the Mass Effect games, was that the writing was great, the story was great. So, side job?
They pulled me off the mission, just like when they forced you to give up the Normandy.
I know, I'm sorry. I wanted to warn you, but there was no way to get a message to you before you docked. I know you're pissed off right now, but you can't give up. They all think this is over, but we both know it's not. You have to go to Ilos. You have to stop Saren from using the conduit.
But
there's only one ship that can get me into the Terminus systems undetected, and she's grounded.
Citadel controls locked out all the Normandy's systems, but if we override the Ambassador's orders, we can get them to bring the Normandy back online. You can be in the Terminus systems before anyone even knows you're gone.
What's the plan?
I can unlock the Normandy from one of the consoles in the Citadel Control Center. You'll have a few minutes before anyone realizes what happened.
That's a restricted area patrolled by armed guards. How are you going to get in?
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're in the Normandy when the systems come back online.
Well, you could do worms. Then you can name the store, I Got Worms. You already have horses, right? I don't like any of these responses. Well, I can't just, okay. I'll do it. I got it. I understood you.
There's gotta be a better way.
Ambassador Udina issued the lockdown order. If I can hack into the computer in his office, maybe I can override it.
He won't just stand by while you use his computer.
Hopefully he won't be there. If he is, I'll just have to think of something.
The Ambassador won't forgive this, Captain. You'll be charged with treason, a capital offense.
We don't have a lot of options. I break into the Ambassador's computer, or I take my chances with the patrols in Citadel Control.
Don't care.
It's your call, Captain.
I'll break into the Ambassador's office. He made this personal. You ready to get the hell off this station, Commander?
Let's do it.
I'll take care of the lockdown. You get down to the Normandy and tell Joker to stand by.
Well, make sure that there's actually a need first, otherwise you'll just have goats. No reason. But what I was gonna say about the horrors is... Wait, what am I supposed to do? Just go sit at the Normandy? I'm trying to fix this damn...
Am I being, soldier? Can I take a moment of your time?
No, you can't. I'm trying to fix these damn headphones. I'll keep catching on the desk every time I stand up. No, I'm not. Remember Shanksy?
No blood for aliens.
It was doing an autosave there, so I thought there was going to be a cutscene.
You're the Spectre, right?
This isn't where I wanted to go. How do I get to my ship? It would be the goat farm, yar. How the fuck do I get to my ship? I don't even actually know what I was supposed to do. How do I get to my ship?
I hope he's okay.
Thank you. Well, I hope my ship's down here.
Coming up in a report later today, Emily Wong investigates corruption on the Citadel and uncovers a full-blown crime syndicate.
None of this looks familiar.
I've told you before, you're not allowed in here.
This one believes it has the right to move freely through this area.
You're creating a public disturbance. It's against Citadel regulations.
This one is unsure why the other will not be.
I'm really getting tired of this. Where the fuck is my goddamn ship? Why do I have to look up the simplest things in this game? Is my ship. Okay, there's a where the hell is my ship? So I'll do that one. wards, C-Sec. HQ, take the big elevator in the center of the room up to the Alliance dock. Alright, now I remember.
In breaking news, Chairman Burns of the Parliament Subcommittee on Transhuman Studies has been kidnapped by biotic extremists. The biotics commandeered a freighter and were last seen in the Hades Gamma Cluster. No demands have yet been made.
Haven't cared about your news reports once, dude.
Contamination in progress.
Anderson, what are you doing here? I didn't set.
Good man.
Let's go. Get us out of here, Joker. Now.
Commander, we've got company.
Have their sensors picked us up yet?
Well, stealth systems are engaged. Unless we get close enough for a visual, they won't have any idea we're here.
Picking up some strange readings from the planet's surface.
Take us down, Joker. Lock in on the coordinates.
Negative on that, Commander. The nearest landing zone's 2 clicks away.
We'll never make it in time on foot. Get us something closer.
There is nowhere closer. I've looked.
Drop us in the Mako.
You need at least 100 meters of open terrain to pull off a drop like that. The most I can find near Saren is 20.
20 meters? We're never getting close enough for a drop.
We have to try.
God, this riding is
find
bad.
Find another landing zone.
Yeah, it's a new
there
plan.
There is no other landing zone!
The descent angle's too steep.
It's our only option.
It's not an option, it's a suicide run. We don't...
I can do it.
Joker?
I can do it.
Gear up and head down to the Mako. Joker, drop us right on top of that bastard.
Bye, Ashley. Haha. Much better.
Get inside this bunker before Saren finds the con.
There's no way we're getting past that door with brute force.
Saren found some way to open it. There must be some kind of security override somewhere in this complex.
We'll have to find some way to get it up and running again.
I think my teammates are comparatively useless in combat. But I was hoping to get a lot of points. Oh well. Every fucking time I get back into something, there's always a wall, there's always something. I can't maneuver around anything. Better than a sparrow, it's still better than a sparrow, it's still better than a sparrow, it's still better than a sparrow. hey, look, all my guys came back. Ow. Not hitting him because of an invisible wall, or I'm about to kill him even though I'm just shooting his knee a bunch. So Chase, did you end up seeing me do the, did you go back to the beginning of that one Final Fantasy video and watch me level really quickly? What? Fuck you. Oh, I forgot to sell a bunch of shit. Fuck. I can't go back to the ship now. something that came up. I have ideas on how to make the stream. Things to do with the stream. However, two things. One of them is that most of the ideas are... they would be almost pointless without a lot of people actually watching. So I have to get to that point first. In fact, that's where I feel like I'll actually shine, is I feel like I can be a lot funnier when I'm bouncing off of other people, when I'm responding to things in chat. That's where I find my most success in groups. I can usually walk into a room and just know I can make everyone in this room laugh. All I did was go down and come back up. What the hell? But more people, the better. And so there are things like that I'll have to worry about later. But another thing, so there are smaller things that I could do in the meantime. I just need to put the work into it. And Exus, we took an hour-long walk. We talked about a number of things, but one of them was the stream in that guy's channel. And she said, I want you to keep going at it. So I should spend the time on it. But another thing is, what is it that you guys want? You guys, my regulars that are actually here, what is it that you guys want? Not necessarily particular games, but just what is it that you want out of the stream? What is it that... Oops. I guess there's literally no way to get more specific on that. What is it that you want? I'm interested. Unlimited tacos. Okay. Well, I can't do that. And you know what? I'm breaking open crates because I have no use for Omnigel. I don't know what the hell you said it was for, but nope. Something that other streamers have done too. Some things I just haven't got around to doing, some things I don't want to do, but it's... I want to figure it out. One of the things about... it's kind of one of those self-defeating things, like you can't get work experience without getting work, but work requires you to have experience before they'll hire you. One of the, you know, those stupid things. The thing about streaming is, the stream itself would be better if there were more people in the room. But you have to have more people in the room for the stream to get better. So... hey, Taco Bell tacos are fucking delicious. I don't give a fuck what they're made out of. They could be putting people in there. I don't give a fuck. They're delicious. So, I don't know why people get all over Taco Bell tacos. I would like Doritos Locos Tacos delivered straight to my house every day. I would quit the fucking diet for those things. Fucking do that every time. I love Taco Bell. Well, your stomach needs to shut up. Alright, I still didn't get rid of everything because I can't get rid of one of the things if I don't have a certain someone with me. Ah, here we are. Well, I don't have many of these. They are real tacos. What the fuck is fake about them? Are you eating plastic? No, then they're fucking real food. I don't understand people. So the name of the place has to be in Spanish, and you have to see actual not American people back in the kitchen making them for you. This place is one big fucking mess. But can we get back to the subject? Not fucking tacos. I wasn't talking about tacos. Fuck, am I always out of grenades? Why can't the game give me grenades? These enemies and they don't have anything on them. Stupid. What did I ask about? What do you want from the stream? As a regular, what do you want from the stream? I can try to figure out ways to make the stream better myself, but I'm interested in what viewers actually. Okay, progress, maybe. I need to save. Of course I can't save. Why can't I save? Now I can save. Elevators are no save zones. Yeah, it's my channel, but I'm doing it for others. I could sit at home and play a hell of a lot more comfortably on the couch and not fucking with software. I'm doing this for the audience, so I'm just curious. I bet it counts all those upgrades I have. I need to get rid of those as well. So, let's see. Yeah. Look at all that. Why? Such a bad game. God damn it. Inventory management. So fun. Streamer's delight right here. Or was that a chest? Oh no, that's definitely not it. I do not want to do that. Otherwise I'd still be playing Dead by Daylight. These enemies. They're a bitch to fight against, but they're not annoying. It's not so much what game to play, more as do I need to behave differently? Do I need to always have something up to chat about? Do I need to run games? Do I need to do FAQs? Do I need to do chat games, that sort of shit. I wouldn't want to do a lot of those things, but I want to know what people are wanting. It's what they want is still an interest, something that I'm interested in. Thank you. fucking hit Y. Every time I hit Y, I die. I meant to hit resume. Oops. How? Fucking game. Great, I'm stuck. This fucking game. Yeah, that's the thing, I don't even know what it's for. See, right now, I mean, for example, if I come back from PAX and I have, okay, I'm gonna sell stuff, but you need these coin things. You and Crash are the only ones. You guys are over 200 right now. He's at 225, you're at 247. The next person is at 56. Even Chase, who's here a lot, has only been counted for 19 minutes of watching. He's got other things going on at the same time. So the system is a bit of... It needs work to get better. But still, I mean, that encourages people to actually watch, and that's fine. That's cool, bad, but... If I were to say, okay, so I'm doing these for 50, that would mean that three people could even buy. But for you guys, it would be, oh yeah, I can afford those things. So yeah, sure, here, it's change. So...
We got them all, Shepard.
It's just... That's another one of those systems that I feel is better once the channel gets bigger. There are a lot of things going around. I like what Kang does with his, with the betting, but the problem with the betting is, and it's not like Kang is at fault for doing this, it's his decision to do it, it's fine. He's not doing any of the points as far as I know of, he's just letting people mess around with them. But it is a way to engage chat, you get to bet, puts it up on the screen, you get to make bets on, will he survive, will he die, will he kill three people, blah blah. So that's a way to engage chat stuff, but that seems, honestly, to be more for the younger ones. I talked about this before, I'm not playing this for kids. Because I'm not going to hold myself to be family friendly, because I can't. But... what's more entertaining for the people, more, you know, adults that I want to chat with. here's a question. Game selection.
Something's in the way. Destination locked.
I have. Why am I playing Mass Effect right now? It's an old game. I want to be a channel that's playing the new stuff so people are interested. But here I am playing Mass Effect. Well, I'm doing it because there's a sequel coming out, so.
I can't make it.
Whether I've played these or not. You know, it doesn't really matter if I'm ready and. To jump right into a new game. It's more about the viewer's content, so.
I can't make it.
I really wish you would stop being stupid right now. And. But is this a waste of time? Should I be spending the streaming time, you know, maybe play this in the off time, but spend streaming time playing something relevant, something new? They get down to little health, it seems like it always takes a lot more extra heat's worth of bullets to take that little last bit off and make it zero. So my choice to play Mass Effect is absolutely subject to criticism. Am I doing right by doing this? No right answer, but majority rules usually. Thing is a schedule. There's an example of something that isn't of something that you would ask of a streamer. Would you ask of a streamer, please get a schedule so I know when to turn on and see you? I've never had one, but should I? So I called up a baddie who's not doing anything. Well, you can't do anything about time zones. Upstairs. Well, it was one of the... Usually it's an enemy, but I called it up using a thingy. A terminal.
Come on, Saren's already got a head start. We have to go find him before he reaches the conduit.
Can you stop repeating known information, you badly written character?
That's a chance we'll have to take.
Hold on. Something's happening.
Too late. Unable to... Invading fleets. No escape.
Sounds like some kind of message, but I don't recognize the language.
It's probably in Prothean. This recording must be 50,000 years old. No wonder we can't understand it.
The message is all broken up, but I recognize some of the words. It's a warning against the Reaper invasion.
Incredible. The cipher must have transferred an understanding of the Prothean language into your mind.
Not safe. Seek refuge. Inside the archives.
What's it saying? Can you make out anything useful?
Vault Reapers. The Citadel. Overwhelmed. Only hope.
Act of desperation. The conduit. All is lost.
It said something about the conduit, but it's too degraded to help. We should go.
Cannot be stopped. Cannot be stopped.
Oh, I'm glad they put this in here. Am I fucking stuck again? Why?
This place feels wrong to me. And not just because of the Geth.
Why does the game do this to me?
There are secrets here that were meant to be forgotten.
Wait to be done with this game. I have to save after every fight because I might walk into a fucking piece of gum. Hopefully the companions aren't just entirely useless in the next couple games. God, combat sucks in this game. Sometimes hitting him and sometimes not. Backing me into the cover against the wall that's just the fucking hallway.
Unless he's our...
Hold on.
It's probably
a message.
There are secrets here that were meant to be forgotten.
Music go. Why can I not go back the way that I came? Thank you.
thought Saren would have set some kind of trap or ambush for us. They must have been in too much of a hurry.
Or we just haven't run into it yet.
What are all those things on the wall? Some kind of containers?
They look like stasis bombs. The Protheans probably tried to keep themselves alive through cryogenic freezing. Something must have gone wrong. It's a trap! Saren must have set an ambush!
I don't think Saren's behind this.
Got it.
Cutscene time.
You are not Prothean, but you are not machine either. This eventuality was one of many that was anticipated. This is why we sent our warning through the beacons.
Looks like some kind of VI program. Pretty badly damaged.
I do not sense the taint of indoctrination upon any of you. Unlike the other that passed recently, perhaps there is still hope.
Wait a minute. How come I can understand you? Why aren't you speaking the Prothean language?
I have been monitoring your communication since you arrived at this facility. I have translated my output into a format you will comprehend. My name is Vigil. You are safe here for the moment, but that is likely to change. Soon, nowhere will be safe.
Why did you bring me here?
You must break a cycle that has continued for millions of years. But to stop it, you must understand, or you will make the same mistakes we did. The Citadel is the heart of your civilization and the seat of government, as it was with us, and as it has been with every civilization that came before us. But the Citadel is a trap. The station is actually an enormous mass relay, one that links to dark space. The empty void beyond the galaxy's horizon. When the Citadel relay is activated, the Reapers will pour through, and all you know will be destroyed.
If he turns on the relay, the Reapers can wipe out the Council and the Citadel fleet in one fell swoop.
That was our fate. Our leaders were dead before we even realized we were under attack. The Reapers seized control of the Citadel, and through it, the mass relays. Communication and transportation across our empire were crippled. Each star system was isolated, cut off from the others. Easy prey for the Reaper fleets. Over the next decades, the Reapers systematically obliterated our people. World by world, system by system, they methodically wiped us out.
Some of you must have managed to survive.
Through the Citadel, the Reapers had access to all our records, maps, census data. Information is power, and they knew everything about us. Their fleets advanced across every settled region of the galaxy. Some worlds were utterly destroyed. Others were conquered, their populations enslaved. These indoctrinated servants became sleeper agents under Reaper control. Taken in as refugees by other Protheans, they betrayed them to the machines. Within a few centuries, the Reapers had killed or enslaved every Prothean in the galaxy. They were relentless, brutal, and absolutely thorough.
You said you brought me here for a reason. Tell me what I need to do.
The conduit is the key. Before the Reapers attacked, we Protheans were on the cusp of unlocking the mysteries behind mass relay technology. Ilos was a top-secret facility. Here, researchers worked to create a small-scale version of a mass relay. One that linked directly to the Citadel, the hub of the relay network.
Conduit's not a weapon. It's a backdoor onto the Citadel.
What happened next?
We severed all communication with the outside, and our facility went dark. The personnel retreated underground into these archives. To conserve resources, everyone was put into cryogenic stasis. I was programmed to monitor the facility and wake the staff when the danger had passed. But the genocide of an entire species is a long, slow process. Years passed, decades, centuries. The Reapers persisted, and my energy reserves were dwindling.
How did you survive?
I began to disable the life support of non-essential personnel. First support staff, then security. One by one, their pods were shut down to conserve energy. Eventually, only the stasis pods of the top scientists remained active. Even these were in danger of failing when the Reapers finally retreated back through the Citadel relay.
There were hundreds of stasis pods out there. You just shut them down? You killed them?
He couldn't let everyone die. Better to sacrifice some so others could live.
This outcome was not completely unforeseen. My actions were a result of contingency programming entered on my creation.
I bet they didn't tell the non-essential staff about this contingency.
I saved key personnel. When the Reapers retreated, the top researchers were still alive. My actions are the only reason any hope remains. When the researchers woke, they realized the Prothean species was doomed. There were only a dozen individuals left, far too few to sustain a viable population. Yet they vowed to find some way to stop the Reapers from returning. A way to break the cycle forever. And they knew the Keepers were the key.
Aren't they under the influence of the Reapers?
The Keepers are controlled by the Citadel. Before each invasion, a signal is sent through the station compelling the Keepers to activate the Citadel relay. After decades of feverish study, the scientists discovered a way to alter this signal. Using the conduit, they gained access to the Citadel and made the modifications. This time, when Sovereign sent the signal to the Citadel, the Keepers ignored it. The Reapers are trapped in dark space.
Saren can use the conduit to bypass all the Citadel's external defenses.
Correct. And once inside, he can transfer control of the station to Sovereign. Sovereign will override the Citadel systems and manually open the relay, and the cycle of extinction will begin again.
I'll stop Saren. Just tell me how.
There's a data file in my console. Take a copy when you go. When you reach the Citadel's master control unit, upload it to the station. It will corrupt the Citadel's security protocols and give you temporary control of the station. It might give you a chance against Sovereign.
Wait, where's the Citadel's master control unit? I've never heard of anything like that.
Through the conduit. Follow Saren. He will lead you to your destination.
Saren's got enough of a head start. Grab that data file and let's go.
The one you call Saren has not reached the conduit. Not yet. There is still hope if you hurry.
Bit of this game, and I was just sitting here watching it.
So many races looked up to the Protheans as paragons of civilization. They were fooled by the Reapers, just as we were.
So we have a house reserved for VidCon. I love how I don't get directions for fucking anything. Why is this so bad? I'll wait for you. You do you. This thing is a piece of shit. It is close to as bad as the Sparrow. But not quite. It's not all the way there.
We don't have time to admire the view. We have to get through that relay, and these Geth aren't going to make it easy on us.
assistance. Please begin emergency evacuation.
Well, now his day is tipped over. Of course it does. Game's turned down a little. I'm gonna go ahead and call it here. I know it's shorter than usual, but still, it's been over 2 hours. I've got a lot to do tonight, but what I think I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to start the stream again tomorrow morning. I ended up not going to sleep until after 9 or 10 in the morning today, so I might as well make use of that. I'll start another stream in the morning and continue through more of the story. So hopefully we can get out of this damn game as soon as possible. So I will, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow for you, but not for me. So, thank you for jumping in.